Hey guys, you broke repairs and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Bronco Chroma. Where last time left off, I was just... Things were not going my way. Hopefully, this episode will be different. As I think, I'm about to take on Benfica in the first leg of the semi-final of the Portuguese Cup. I'm going to use the second team because I do have a league match in a few days. And as I said, this is the first leg, so there is the second leg. If I don't get the desired result.
It is a country that has produced...
Of course, I've already played Benfica season at their ground and beat them in the very first match of the season. So, or is it the second match? I know it was in the first, it was one of the first two. Next to Zane.
This is the team Benfica are going to field today. Hugo Cesar plays in goal.
And I hope it's a different referee than I had in the last game. Because I should have had two. Well, yeah, it is definitely a different referee, because I was just about to say I should have had two penalties in my last match. Neither were given. At least this one was given, and now an early opportunity to take the lead. Yeah, clearly a penalty. It has Munir on it. Even Hernandez has 81 penalties. Why would he not be taking them?
Good penalty.
Yes. Back in the net. And it's 1-0 inside 8 minutes. Fantastic.
It's a lovely penalty by Abel Hernández. The way he strode up to that ball and placed it to the...
Ataca Portugal. Prize that out.
Now back to throw.
So... That's a good start, right? Also, it's an away goal. I don't know if away goals will count if it comes down to that. Hopefully it won't. But if they do, if it need be, I have the away goal. I have a away goal.
Oh, in goes across.
How easily dealt with. Don't think I can stop the counter attack.
Oh, he's true.
Jota straight, who you say that? I should have squared it to one of my strikers. This is my bad. Dembele. And go for that little, good challenge. Oh, and they avoid the corner at the expense of a throw on the opposite side. Instead, Josu wins the corner anyway. If you're wondering, who the hell is Josu? I'm playing him because Augusto was a bit tired, so I decided to play Josu instead. Looks like he's on the corner. Jorginho. And then there's Jota. Straight at the keeper again. Aim for a side, perhaps? Jota? Just a hint. No? Aim for a side. I don't aim it straight at where the keeper is. So assume he'll just dive because he sees you short in the ball.
Abel Hernández. Benfica have the ball.
Challenge by Jardel, but won back by Hernández.
Place to try and hit it now.
In here. Jota! Off the post!
a good clearance because it's got the ball well out of harm's way.
Dembele. Hernandez! Yes! That is an extreme bit of luck, but I will take it. 2-0. Oh, fantastic. Great crossing from Dembele. Oh, to his striker, Hernandez. Cesar gets to a foot to it, but only ends up putting it in the net anyway. And it is 2-0. I don't think that will go that. I think, that is an Abel Hernandez goal. That's a good few goals he's gotten already. And not so, in a short amount of matches. As Abel Hernandez. This is why I've been considering dropping Henson and playing Hernandez in the first team. Dembele can make a 3. Oh, he hit straight Cesar. I could have passed it to, I think that was Adrizio, who was running in for the would have been tapping for 3-0.
Stop the game for the free kick.
Sure what I did, but apparently I fell. Benfica player. Yo, countered. Heck, it's 2v1. It's 3v1. It's 4v1. And it's gotta be a goal. Jota, off the crossbar. Are you serious? After an amazing run, we were 4v1 and you hit the crossbar. Brilliant work. As always, Jota. He scored 2 goals in the last episode. Great, it was an assumed match. The second leg against Rubin Kazan. But he still scored them. Anyway, I'll take 2-0. Crossbar. Hurrah. Crossbar hit. Disappointing, but, not. It doesn't affect us yet. It's not. It's not. Like, it's 0-0, and that was to. Like, in the last couple of minutes. 2-0, just going into the second half.
The referee awards a free kick. Yeah.
Maybe 1-2 more goals in this second half and finish Benfica off, and I'll be able to prepare for the final. Probably at the end of the season. Wow, really, Dembele? Probably should have taken a touch. I was just a bit wary with the defender. And if I'd taken a touch, he would have tackled the ball.
On top of his game.
Yeah, it was too cautious, perhaps. In the air. Bye. Hernandez. Oh, he saved it. And the flag has gone up against Hernandez because it smacked him in the face as he was as it was coming through, and he is miles offside.
Well, the losing team have got to do something, and this is it, the substitution.
Hernandez. Did he get it? Nope. Andres Samaris. A bit tired. The crossbar again? Are you serious? I think that was it was Ringstead, my left back, hits the crossbar this time. And then Dembele hits the post. So if it both would work, it's twice. Penalty. Thank you. And here is Leo Hernandez's chance to finish his hat trick. It's another defensive yellow card for Benfica. Elisu, the Benfica left back, if I'm not mistaken. This time. It has Jota on it again. I'll have to set it to be Hernandez every time. Oh wow, he went the same way he says or died this time, but he's not prevent everyone Hernandez from completing the hat trick, and it is indeed 3-0.
Super celebration. To get a hat trick is a fantastic experience, and he's just done that.
Well, having scored two, he was just so full of confidence, and he never looked like missing that chance.
That's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
I'm definitely Oh wow, that's another foul. That's another yellow card. Benfica are racking him up here. This is gonna be the it's a red! It's a straight red for Samaras. Pronouncing his name wrong, but yeah, he's not gonna be playing in the second leg. Benfica are down to 10 men.
Of the referee taking serious action.
Well, it is. He saw the ball and he thought he could win it.
I guess I could see how it was given as a head card.
Wasn't quite the goal.
I think the keeper might have believed there, Martin, because
poor free kick. Pretty standard, their business. Pretty standard stuff there for me. He really. Now take Dembele off and bring on Benzia. Munir's looking a bit tired. I was going to bring Heze on, but I want him to be fully fit for the game in the next few days.
It's been called a football match, but it hasn't been much of a match.
So I'll only make the one substitution and see it coming on for Moussa Dembele.
Just aching to hear the final whistle now. I've seen Benzia. Pizzi.
And I run straight into the Benfica player, which is brilliant. So, offside!
What a fine save.
Munir. Needs help here. There we go. Benzia, those fresh legs. Against a 10-man defense. Hernandez again wins the corner. Lucao.
Seem to be happy with the substitution. They weren't. Well,
that was actually his last contribution because Lopez. Not sure who that is.
Julio Cesar holds on.
Seems to be a call Lopez at Benfica last week. But maybe he was there. The defender had to be careful. That pushing could have easily been given as another penalty. What were the odds to get three penalties in one match? I wouldn't imagine that's a pretty high possibility. Munir. Benzia, handball. Imagine. If I had handballs on, I probably would have been a penalty. I'll take 3-0. Williams, 10-man Benfica. I couldn't actually capitalize on the fact that they went down to 10 men. I scored all my goals beforehand. So Salvio and Alessio were both shown yellow, and Samaras, again, probably saying his name wrong, was sent off. Not a good day for Benfica in terms of discipline. This pretty pointless to me, man. where if I see Port or Sporting or maybe both dropping more points. They haven't played yet. Hang on 1 second. Saying Porto beat Sporting. Oh wait, I think that might have been in the cup. Yeah, Porto playing Gumejeres. Probably said their name wrong. Typical old fashion. Saying all names wrong. Let's see. Hernandez is too tired to start. So I'll use him as an impact sub. Hansen, you have to be on your toes because he just scored a hat trick. From knew I wanted the goal news from Porto. Brilliant. Hopefully Porto can drop more points. I'm already 19 ahead and 10 games remaining. I could make it 22 if I win and they lost.
Side. Don't always say it these days.
Go straight in for an early
control. They have got a good partnership, a good understanding.
Alfonso Mascarenhas.
Traore. He scored in the last episode. First goal in about 5 games, but he scored.
Nicely lined up for the set piece specialist here with this free kick.
I'm not going to take the free kick. Quick. I'm gonna have a go! Ooh.
I don't think he could have hit that one much better.
He's never gonna go in, but
yeah, he's got some dip on it, but it just didn't come soon enough.
Not decently close. Also giving myself that.
It's gonna be very tough for the opposition today to break down the home team's defense.
Oh.
Very few teams have broken them down.
And of course Hansen runs straight into the opposition. My fault. Yesterday. To the man. Make the run, Hansen. Yes. Penalty! Okay. What? How's that not a penalty? I know we got two in the last test match, but come on, that is a stone cold penalty.
Shot making the goalkeeper's job pretty routine.
That is bullshit is what that is. The league does not want to give me penalties. That's 3 in 2 league games I've not been given. That could have easily been a... That would have at least been a yellow, if not a red as well, because that was a goal... Actually, it would have been a red. That was a goal-scoring opportunity. I would have scored if he hadn't taken me out. So, ref, you've completely fucked up, you fucking numpty twat. Not only have you failed to give me a penalty, you failed to send the offender off.
Offside is the call. We can see it again.
For denying a goal-scoring opportunity, because it would have been a goal. Well, I was clean through. one goal.
But they had to work hard for the away win.
Again, I said this in the last episode. Look at that. Go back and watch the foul again and tell me it was not a penalty. It's the third one. I should have been given. That one was worse than the two. In the last league game, the two could have easily been given as the most yellow card. For it. If they'd gotten warnings, I wouldn't have raged. But that was a red card offense. I should have been the second sending off in as many games in this episode. But instead, there was no penalty and no card. Traore! Yes! Maybe he's broken the goal scoring drought. Maybe he's back.
It is certainly the kind of match that we thought we were coming here to see. The better team.
Two goals in two games for now. Tough return. Right after. Not scoring in about five or six.
On that goal.
And I will take it.
That has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Not received any updates from Porto. Again, I wasn't really paying attention to the top corners to see if any flashed up. It probably did flash up, but I just didn't see it. I'll see you at halftime.
Opportunity now! Oh, well saved! Back off the post!
Are you freaking kidding me? Trying to shoot with a number 8. Neves should have scored. The ball rolled past one of my players who just didn't seem interested in shooting, even though I was pressing the circle button to get him to shoot.
Well, that's gone back.
And by the way, I'm pretty sure it's that number 5 youth defender for the opposition who's the guy who should have been sent off. I think that's who it is, anyway. I think it was a single goal. I will look back over it at the end of the match. Or half time.
Free kick given.
Oh, but that's a foul. Fuck you, referee. Wins the ball. I was on an attack. Heck. Fuck face. Porto are drawing 1-1. I'm glad, I heard about those two goals. Yeah, again, I said they might have popped up and I just didn't take any notice. 2 minutes. Come on. The defender did his job, to be fair to him. He impeded Timmins fairly, unlike the other defender in the first half. I'm not going to let that go. That was a penalty, and it was a red card, because that would have been a goal otherwise.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well...
I don't say that lightly. It was freaking Hansen who had the... Oh, he doesn't know. Or unless it's gifted to him. See? He puts the ball in the net when he's offside. He more times than he does when he's onside. If all his offside goals stood, he'd have more than Traore. So many times the guy, he gets himself offside. Santos, finish it! Boom! Top corner! That is beautiful! 2-0. Well done, my friend. Well done.
And the keeper dives, but really he's wasted his time. It's still right at the top left-hand corner.
seventh goal of the season. Well, seventh league goal of the season. And he might have a few in the Europa League. I'm remembering at this time.
Here's a chance to move forward.
Hansen. Drury. Bury it. Hansen! Of course. There's not.
Winner this lad, but today no, and it was one of his lesser performances. I think it's a bit hard on him.
I'd love to know what happened. I don't know, was it offside? It didn't see a flag.
Sometimes you are dependent on your service and obviously dependent on what you do with the ball.
I'm gonna guess it was offside, or maybe one of my players was judged to have fouled the opposition player. Well, I know that should have been 3-0. Well, because I didn't see a flag, so I'm going to assume it was a foul. Like that was. No, no, of course not. I didn't know this team was secretly Man City, because they must have tons of fucking money that they're lining this referee's pocket with. How much he's freaking clearly on their... her side. The fact that they didn't give the penalty or send defender off in the first half. He's giving phantom fouls. Plus, he's not giving me anything. You know, unless it's blatantly obvious. It's bullshit.
Be a throw to the opposition.
Yeah, I know.
And in the shot go.
Great run from the right back. Oh. Don't just stand there till the man's. Stood there for a bit like he completely forgot what to do. SA! Oh!
Corner now.
Come on, SA, do better than that. Neves. Volley! Would you admit? Oh, SA! I think he was offside. Or is the linesman flagging? Yeah, he's flagging for offside. Still, oh, it was my fault for hitting X instead of freaking circle. I know it wouldn't have counted, but still, I shouldn't have made that mistake. Try, there we go, there's 3-0, there's the 3 points wrapped up. Hopefully Porto have done their job, dropped some points, and I can go 22 square? I'll take 20. Actually, it'd be 21, wouldn't it? Because if they draw, they get 1 point, not two. Football would be a lot different if it was 2 points for a draw.
Where there's life, there's hope, but there's not much life in the game.
Well, I think we're going to see some Route 1 stuff here, Martin, in the next few minutes. Might not be pretty, but I'd be hoping it'd be effective.
No, no, of course not. Of course that wasn't a foul. He just muscled me off the ball. Oh, don't give a foul. Oh, you daft tit.
We've got 2 added minutes. That's been signaled now. I've got the ball in the middle of the pitch here.
Hansen threw on goal again. One-on-one with the goalkeeper. Of course he doesn't score because it's Hansen. There's the full-time whistle. It doesn't matter anyway.
Well, one team's coming off looking pretty fresh.
3-0. Oh, wrapped up. 2 goals from Trey. And 1 from Santos. Gives me the 3 points. It's his best game for a while. Well, after or five or six games a while ago. Well, he has 3-2 games. Maybe he is indeed back. Now, of course not. Of course it's not there. Of course it's not there. Oh, here we go, 41, look at that, that is a penalty, that is a penalty. 41. Well, I was kind of right, his numbers did add up to 5, he wasn't 5. Porto did drop 2 points, that is fantastic, so it is 21 points the gap, unless Sporting win. What's Sporting going to win? What? You just know they're probably going to win. I don't mean over West Ham. That's the Europa League. That doesn't affect the league. I guess I have to sim to... I was going to do that anyway. But... Ricardo Ferrer. One of my backup center backs. Well, I'll be gone in the next window, so no. Alright, let's check. Come on. Give me good news. Give me the good news. Is it 21 points? Or is it still 19? Damn it, it is still 19. Sporting did win. Damn it! So the gap is still 19 points, with 9 games remaining. It's getting so close to that title, I can feel it. And I might, yeah, I was going to say, I thought the Sporting game was after the second leg. I do have Sporting in my next league game. So I will be opening the gap further. And depending on the result in the first leg of the LA Bilbao game, I might fit in the third game against Benfica. So don't miss the next episode. It's going to be a very good one. And where the title will be so... Actually, let me just think. If I beat Sporting, then they will be... 22 points behind. With 8 games remaining. They wouldn't be out of it just yet. But Benfica might. So I can win it in the next episode if results go my way. I don't know who's. Porto. Oh my god, I've never won Porto. Oh, win a match so badly. If Porto beat Sporting, and I beat Sporting. If I beat Sporting and Benfica, and Porto beat Sporting in the next episode, depending on the result again, I will have to absolutely smash the Bilbao so I can simulate that second leg and get the title in the next episode. Do not miss it. It's going to be fantastic if everything goes to plan. And smash the like button if you enjoyed this episode, because I know you did. Hit the like button if you are new to the channel. Also, you do not miss that crucial episode next Saturday. Hey, and until next time. I hope you all have a very